Hello, Herman here with a new video in the ClearPass Workshop series where we built a ClearPass deployment from scratch and integrate with wired, wireless, Active Directory and much more. I had a lot of requests to create videos around OnGuard, so here we go. In this video I'll do an introduction on the workflows of OnGuard and how you can install the agent. And in the next video we'll start building policies and doing enforcement. So first let's have a look on how the OnGuard workflow is. We have a normal client which can be wired or wireless or even VPN. And it will need to run the OnGuard agent, and that can be done either by installation. We have the agentless method and we have the dissolvable agent, but in the end the client will run the agent, so that's all the same. Client will connect normally to the network. At that point ClearPass doesn't know the posture status, so it will return a role for the unknown, and that can either be a full access role. So then you have immediately full access to the network. And if OnGuard later on reports that there is an issue, then you can put it on a limited access role. Or you can start with the limited role. And then as soon as you know that the posture is healthy, you can open up the access. But at least in either the limited role or the full access role, the agent needs to communicate to the ClearPass server, and there it can request the policy. Then it will do a local policy evaluation, so it will check if the antivirus is running, if the firewall is okay, if processes are running or not running, and then it will respond to the ClearPass server with the policy results. At that point ClearPass will do an evaluation, and then based on the results ClearPass will assign a posture token, and that can be healthy, it can be infected or quarantined. Those are the ones that are mostly used. But the token will stay at the ClearPass server, and after that ClearPass will respond, and it can either trigger a COA, so it can do a port bounce, or it can do a disconnect client, or it can even directly trigger the role change, or it can do a agent bounce. And in that case the agent on the client will do a port bounce, so it will bring the port down and up from the agent side. And at that point there will be a new authentication. ClearPass then knows the token, and it can respond based on the token. So for example, if we have a healthy token, we can respond with the role for the posture status healthy, which probably is an allow all access role. And at that point, the client will have access. Okay, let's have a look in the ClearPass server. Here's my ClearPass server. If we now check our latest .1x authentication, we can see that we have the system posture status of unknown, because we didn't do anything with posture at this point or with OnGuard. That's why we have the posture status unknown, and we don't take any effect of the posture status at this point. Now let's have a look here under administration. Here we have the agent and software updates and the OnGuard settings, and here we can configure our OnGuard. Here we see the version of the OnGuard, and typically that's the same version as you have for the ClearPass. So with every new ClearPass there will be a new version of the agent. Then this is for Linux, let's ignore that. Then here we have the managed interfaces, so on which interfaces should OnGuard be active. Here we have the mode, so by default it's authenticating not doing health checks. Let's here now do a health check without any authentication. Here we can decide what happens if there are updates, so you can ignore them or you can automatically download and install them. Let's do that. Then here we have the remediation action, and you can customize how it will look and feel. Then there are three different ways for the posture agent, so it can be either an installable one, and here are the installers, so you can download it from here and then you can install it, and then afterwards your client will connect to the ClearPass server. We also have the dissolvable agents, so these are automatically displayed from a web page, and then users can download it, run it once. The agent will post the posture results, and then the captive portal will respond with a change of authorization. And we have something called agentless OnGuard, and this basically is ClearPass reaching out to the client, doing a remote login and pushing the agent to there. So you need to have administrative rights on the clients and push it through that administrative rights from the ClearPass server to your clients. But the benefit is that you don't need to install it on the client. Okay. What we'll start with is the normal installer. So this URL, there's a normal exe file for normal installation, and there's an MSE that you can adapt for rollout through large scale deployment systems. So let's get the exe file. And now let's get to my client. Here is the same URL. I just replaced the IP address with the name. You can download it without any authentication. So here we go. Now we can open it. For the installer, you need to have admin rights. It will run as a service. Select the language. Install. There, run ClearPass OnGuard. It can run automatically. So you see it immediately disappeared. Oh, here we have the prompt. And here we have the agent. So let's cancel this one. So here we have the authentication. But the authentication is failed, and that's weird because we didn't do any authentication. So let's have a look back in the ClearPass and go to our access tracker. Ah, that's it. We had to save these settings because we changed here the health check only. And let's try again. Retry here. Now we need to get the policy. Authentication failed. But now you can see it's not asking for authentication again. And now if we have a look in the access tracker, we can see that we have a reject here. So we need to create a web auth service for this posture client. And that's what we'll do in the next video. Hope this was useful. If you have any questions, you can put them under the video in the comments section or use the Airheads community. And please don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel. Thanks a lot for watching.